One year with the watch, but a year full of heavy usage. The watch was used in constructions and agriculture activities, and now, coming back to it for presentation, I am amazed of how good it looks. I keep to my initial assessment that it have a classic luxury look. The watch is pretty eye-catching. For the money asked, it is kind of a bargain. After 1 year, I find the same cons. I stick to what I have said after unboxing the watch. Although the clasp is not metal pressed, overall the bracelet is a letdown, poor quality, sharp edges and rattling excessively. Now after 1 year, it's rattling even more. But on a leather strap should be okay, since it have this luxury look. The watch itself, it's good enough in quality. Finishing is okay, polished and brushed surfaces are always welcome. The case survived pretty well in 1 year of daily use. Another letdown is the lack of any personalized rotor or any other parts regarding the movement. It was better to be a not see-through case, since viewing the NH35 caliber like it is out of the shelf is just sad to witness. The lume is still poor, despite it is very pleasant to the eye. Blue and green color just add composition. After 1 year, the bezel got loose, too loose. There's a lot of play there, but it is okay-ish. At least, it's still very hard to rotate the bezel accidentally, so once the peep is aligned with the 12 o'clock marker, it should stay firmly in place. For this video, I have brought my Tag Heuer Aquaracer. The similarities between the two are obvious. Bersigar, indeed, it's a homage, but they did such a good job. Now we arrive at the conclusion after 1 year. Carefully designed to offer the right mix of strength and elegant style, perfect to wear on any occasion. The minimalist design on the dial adds a layer of simplicity and a premium appearance. Recommended? Yes, for a budget restraints, because the watch covers all the bases. Ceramic bezel, sapphire glass, screw down crown, it's dressy enough. Casual and sporty in the same time. On a leather strap will be a looker. I have bought the watch out of my curiosity with my own money. I'm not sponsored or involved in any collaboration with any manufacturer whatsoever. Here on my channel, what you see is what you get. To wrap it up, it's a nice budget homage of the Tag Heuer Aquaracer featuring the Seiko NH30A movement. It's worth all the money. This being said, thank you. See you on the next one.